signing of the Appropriations Act yesterday. I was directed by the President to go to the Middle East and prepare the necessary plan of our country to put our countrymen in the Middle East out of harm's way. And he directed me to proceed immediately, and I said yes. Yes, sir. So I am making some preparations, and in fact, at 1 o'clock today, when some of the cabinet secretaries are at the Department of Foreign Affairs now, because we have the president designated a committee to assist this group that will be going to the Middle East. So I'm preparing my travel going there, and I will do my best to do another mission for our country.
Sir, kailan po ang alis nyo? And ano yung itinerary nyo, sir? Ano mga bansa yung pupuntahan nyo po?
Sir? Well, we are supposed to leave within 24 to 48 hours, but I would like to wait for my visa muna so that I can go to my destination in the Middle East as soon as possible.
Saan, sir? Ang muna po na?
I plan to go to Qatar, establish our base there, and from there we'll see if we'll be able to go inside Iraq.
Sa Iraq, sir, wala tayong embassy po. Wala po tayong embassy mismo sa Iraq.
We have still the embassy there, but yes, during my presentation to the President yesterday to the Cabinet, I made some of my personal opinion and of my personal personal thing that I experienced when I was there, what could happen and what should I do in order to save or to put out of harm's way of the Filipinos there. And I saw that we have to move out immediately the Filipinos out of Iraq because I believe that this could be the target initially. It was U.S. facilities inside Baghdad, almost the same area where the Iranian general was killed.
So, sir, it's a forced evacuation for Filipinos. Do they have choice to stay or
in Iraq? Yes, yes. It is really a forced evacuation.
How many, sir, are
we? This was the same what happened during the invasion of Iraq in 2003. 2003.
So, sir, how many Filipinos are there?
Oh, well, they were estimating about 1,000, and we'll check kasi marami pa hindi counted. So, we'll check really. But I've already made some recommendations last night, but we have to inform the embassy there to already move out. In fact, from here, I'm going to DFA and we'll be having finalized some of our plan. And I will reiterate that we have really to move them out immediately.
Sir, kapit sa kanila na same situation po noon, ano kaya yung magiging challenge ngayon? Mas maraming Pilipino na kailangan evacuate?
Well, the situation before was that there was this invasion by the U.S. forces, British, joint U.S. and British forces to topple the Saddam Hussein regime and possibility of the use of interpolation of the weapons of mass destruction. Ito yung mga ano namin yun eh, nag-iingatan. So, if this deteriorates, affected the whole of Middle East, and we were prepared for a plan for a possibility like that in the previous experience. This time it is also very similar, but this time the players or the actors or the protagonists are already, is different already. It is between a possible retaliation by the Iranian against the US forces there and the threat to the Filipinos, because we are not combatants, we are not part of the problem, but the only possible threat against our Filipinos is that in case of some retaliation, almost always they target the some possible U.S. Areas as U.S. forces there. And around that facilities of the U.S. Forces, there are Filipinos. So these are the possible threat that might come. And therefore, we have to make preparations. And the best way for the moment is for them to leave Iraq immediately.
Sir, saan sa'yo dadalhin kung sa pilot? I mean, initially, yung mga i-evacuate po, saan yung po initially dadalhin muna?
Well, yes. We are already making some plans. In fact, mamaya na, the logistics on it. And in fact, I just would like to preempt about the announcement of the Secretary Tugade. There is a vessel that can be used. It is a Coast Guard vessel that will be deployed back out of the Philippines. I think Baguio yata ito eh. So that it is in Malta now, and ito na ngayon ang pag-usapan namin kung, because in Malta it is very near Libya. Malapit lang yan, in the Mediterranean eh. And there is a problem in Libya. On the problem also in Tripoli. So maaring magamit ito for them to be evacuated also, kasi medyo very, very volatile na rin yan rin sa Libya ngayon. So bago mag- ang plano sana natin is nadalhin sa Arabian area, somewhere in the one of the countries there. So ito sana plano. But in the meantime, I'll be making some recommendation later that we might use this muna for the next 24 to 48 hours para extricate mga Filipinos dyan sa border ng Libya at saka Tunisia in case na mayroon nag-deteriorate ng Libya kasi. And at the same time, mayroong problema dito ngayon, and it is another crisis. So last night, I was scribbling ganito. Then sabi ko, nako, baka the first matamaan dito is the embassy, US Embassy ni Grinson to retaliate. Nag-uusap-usap pa lang kami doon. Then after that, pagbuka sa cellphone nila, tinira na pala. So, kahapon sa ano, kagabi ba yan? Mm-hmm. Lumabas na ba? Yes, ngayon? So, of course, these are plans, and we would like to finalize these plans later with the other kasi. But I have to find out kung saan talaga maaring matarget. So I have an, there are several U.S. Area forces in the Middle East. Where they have the Central Command. U.S. Central Command is in Qatar. The Fifth Fleet is in Bahrain, and of course there are some more forces in Kuwait. So nandiyan na Pilipinos. So kung itong mga target, hindi delikado rin ng mga Pilipinos. So we have to make individual plans in each country. So ito ngayon ang ating mga gagawin.
Sir, gaano katagal po kaya sik ang nakikita niyong that it ay
hapa? Well, that is a very important question, because if there is a declaration of war already, and this becomes a protracted long term NATO, Iran versus US, especially their ano noon their agreement about nuclear. Ibabawasan yung nuclear. Pero ngayon, yung moment na medyo nawala na yan, it is becoming more ano na ngayon. More dangerous. Ito yung mga possibilities na maaaring mangyari. It can be a short one, which we hope that that should be, that should ano mangyayari lang, but not a protracted na labanan nila.
Any meron na po bang recommendation to elevate the alert level, sir, dun sa yung level po ng alert, meron po ba tayo?
Well, yes, the highest level of alert in Iraq as of yesterday was 3, level 3, meaning voluntary repatriation. So I recommended for a upgrade already by last night for a level 4. They have to move out. But the other countries, ano lang, nag-raise lang sila ng level, level 2 yata, until level 2 to level 3. Malalaman natin mamaya.
Sir, na-mention na po kasi mayroon yung plano niyo para sa Pilipino sa Iraq. How about po yung mga Pilipino sa Iran in case na?
Oh, well, Secretary Mamao was directed by the President also last night to go there to find out. Kasi hindi kasi documented yung mga Pilipinos dyan sa Iran eh. Wala tayong record and data. So, the President directed the Secretary Mamao to go there to Iran, to Tehran, and check yung mga Pilipinos there, and also to remind, hindi naman to remind that the Filipinos there are working and they are not combatant.
Sir, kasi ang isa pong nababanggit na challenge sa gagawin repatriation is paghahanap po dun sa undocumented OFW.
That's ano? Saan?
Mga undocumented OFW.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Well, that's one of the difficulties really of a lot. I experienced that. I was thinking that ito lang, tapos marami pala nandun na hindi naka-record. So ito na ngayon na i-check ni Secretary Mamao sa Iran.
Ano po kaya yung pwedeng gawin? Kasi mahirap pong i-track kung saan yung location nila.
Matrack.
Mahanap po yung location nila. So ano po yung naiisip po ng Pilipino?
Well, ang pinakmaano talaga dyan is here in Manila. Na-experience na namin yan. Ito, meron silang mga nandoon, itatawag lang yung family nila na meron, nandito kami yung mga may problema rito, very dangerous na rito. Yung parents naman nila rito, yan ngayon magsasabi that they are there. Sa ito yung mga sources namin kung saan talaga sila. So that we know that, tell yung parents nila rito that bibigay lang namin yung mga telephone numbers for them to call so that if they need assistance talaga, ano doon. Ganun lang naman ang way of ano, kasi difficult talaga yan, yung maghanap yung mga undocumented na naka-embed na talaga doon sa mga...
Sir, excuse, last question, kasi di Secretary Mo to move to DFA.
Sir, yung you said 1,000 Filipinos in Iraq, are those documented?
Oh, some are documented. They have the list. Some are undocumented. Yung mga nagtatrabaho doon sa US contractor. May mga contractor kasi na employment contractor ba na nakapaglagay ng mga data nila, documents sila sa DOL, Department of Labor, tapos kompleto tayo dyan. But yung mga hindi nakasama, like for example some US companies na nag-recruit na lang na without passing through the DOL, ito ngayon ang medyo mabigat. Yan sila ngayon na nandun sa Green Zone, sa Baghdad. So ito ngayon natitignan natin.
Sir, clarification lang. Ano sabi ni Pangulo nung sinabi niyo recommendation ng forced evacuation?
Well, sabi niya, ikaw ang ano, pupunta ka doon. And gagawa ka ng plano. Find out, then orchestrate itong mga ano natin. So, yes sir, sabi ko, punta ako doon. Ikaw lang pinaka-experience dito muna. Sabi na sa akin, sige, yes sir. So, ngayon pupunta ako doon. Ang good thing naman is they have already started mobilizing each country na ano na sila, in place na, ready na. So as a matter of ano na lang, which sa mga targets doon, ang kasi guessing game ngayon eh, kung sino ang sabi ko nila, they will give a talagang strong retaliation to wave a strong message of ano kasi na marami ng ano in fact nagkaroon na sila ng mga ano na show of support already. So ito ngayon ang medyo nakataano.
So target niya sir, ngayon week yung start ng forced evacuation.
Kailan nagsisimula? Ngayon lang nagsimula sir. Yung forced evacuation sir. Well, ito na. Mag-umisa nito. Ito na yung era. They are ready ang buwan na yun.
Asap.
We have to, we're looking for ano, mga mode of evacuation na ngayon.
Sir? Thank you very much. Kailan pa pumunta sa DFA si ano, secretary?
Pero sir, ang evacuation is Iraq lang.
Lahat ito.
Lahat na sa middle.
Yes, okay. Marami ako mga target.
Possible target. Pero Iraq.